This is my story of survival after being abandoned by my expedition team on a remote island called King's Mouth. In my quest to endure, I found a massive mansion that now serves as my shelter. It's here that I've gathered tools to fortify my new home, and I've scrounged enough food and water to keep going. Along the way, I've had to fight off relentless hordes of zombies. But beyond these physical challenges, the hardest battle has been internal. The isolation and my deep resentment towards those who left me here has pushed me to the brink, leading to a severe mental breakdown. And this is what happened next in my journey.
We can talk about this. We can talk about this. We're friends, remember? It was Rhodey. It was Rhodey's idea. Please.
It's too late for that.
Ow. This is a dream or... What the fuck? I'm pretty sure that's not heaven. God, I hate this. Well, this is not creepy at all.
Boy,
is that a guy?
Over here! I've been expecting you!
Honey, you came! This is such a wonderful surprise!
Do I know you?
Do I know you? What have they done to you, my poor boy? I am your friend! Remember all the fun we had? Drinking and puffing, getting wasted on a Monday afternoon? We had the best life, but Rhodey ruined it for us. You are not the one who deserves to die. They are. The day of retribution will come, but until then, stay alive for me. Now it's time for you to go back, and there's only one way to do it. Please stand still, keep your arms at your side, and lock your shoulders to avoid a concussion. I'll be quick.
Wait, why are you running? Wait, you're not gonna... Oh,
At around 10:30 that night, I regained consciousness and found myself standing in the library back at the mansion. I no longer felt exhausted, and my head felt empty, like a freshly wiped hard drive. I remember the fight down at the container area. Hordes of zombies emerging from the forest, and me swinging my pipe while my skin clung to my arms as if about to fall off. But what happened after that? Did I black out due to exhaustion? And I felt like I had an absurd dream involving a door and someone with a familiar face. Also, what's with this mild pain at the back of my head? Was it an injury I sustained while fighting zombies? Could one of the zombies have been the black belt in karate? Because it felt more like a kick than anything else. I spent a good minute or two trying to think of anything that could have happened while I was out, but nothing logical came to mind. So as anyone else would have done in this situation, I picked up where I left off and continued adding defenses to the mansion. I spent the entire night chopping trees, reinforcing windows, and covering up the broken doorway in the kitchen. I mean, I could have made reinforcing the exterior wall my priority, but somehow having the kitchen wide open just gives me the jitters. Imagine, you've just opened up a fresh can of dog food, and just as you're about to dig in, a couple zombies get in and catches you standing there holding the can. What would they think of you?
I have a dog?
You might find my logic amusing, but the fact is, my decision saved my life here, okay? And that's right after I shoved this pack of sugar down my throat.
What the fuck?
I heard a gunshot almost immediately after consuming a whole bag of sugar. And judging from the sound, it wasn't very far from me. Could it be Rhodey and Chad? Given the zombie-infested environment and the harsh December weather, it is very possible for them to still be in the area. Or could it be from another group of survivors? Although it's hard to believe that there are survivors on this island still, but the possibility isn't zero. It could also be a misfire, triggered by some kind of coincidence, such as a house catching fire and the ammunition inside getting cooked to a point of exploding. I've seen it happen. Whatever the case, a shot this close to my location will most definitely attract the attention of any nearby zombies, and that is the bad news. So I kept myself in a kitchen storage room away from the door, hoping that I would be able to hide from the zombies. But unfortunately, it wasn't my day.
Man, how did they even know I'm here?
I was spotted. As I opened the door, I was greeted by a decent-sized horde drawn to my mansion by the gunfire. So I went to work. Thanks to my reinforcements, a portion of the horde was distracted and decided to attack the windows and doors. However, the remaining ones were still very difficult to deal with. Outnumbered, I used the same trick that I've used before. I took to the trees and circled around the green room, breaking the line of sight with the horde to create some space. This allowed me to turn back and deal with them one by one.
Monster kill!
It took me 5 hours to get rid of all of them. Feeling famished, I went to the kitchen to grab something to eat. As I opened the cupboard door, I realized that I was running out of food. All I had left was 3 cans of canned food and 1 loaf of moldy bread. Additionally, I was running out of nails. Days of boarding up windows and building walls had exhausted all 200 nails I had found in the garage. I need to go out and find more supplies. So for the following day and a half, I went through the entire mansion, checking on things and made a shopping list of items I desperately need.
Okay, we need more food, more nails, and more cigarettes.
On the chilly morning of December 15th, I left the mansion to explore. My eyes was drawn to a decently sized building to the north. The building was marked as a residential area, but judging by its shape, it could either be a shopping mall or a plaza with series of different stores connected to each other. Now, the building wasn't far from the mansion, but to get there, I needed to travel through this eerily silent forest. I walked as slowly as possible, constantly checking my blind spots. The sound of the wind brushing through the tree branches, the dry, crispy leaves crunching under my feet, the rapid slapping of my backpack strap against my chest, and my heart pounding louder and louder filled the air. I hadn't heard birds for a while now, and in this silence, that could only mean one thing. Zombies. And there were a lot of them. It was like walking back to your car after being one of the 10 people who managed to buy a PS5 on launch day. They were jumping out of windows, trembling over each other's body parts, desperate to get a piece of what you have.
Holy shit, how many are there? Okay, guess that's all of them. Oh, come on.
The purge continued for a few hours. I managed to clear half of the zombies on site to a point where I could access one or two stores without being interrupted. However, I was suffering from serious body fatigue due to excessive exercise, you know what I mean, and that could cause some serious issues if I'm not careful. The first store on the left is a clothing store. I searched the front counter and I found a bunch of socks stacked inside of drawers, which is kind of weird. There were also sodas and snacks on the stand next to the counter. I ate a bag of tortilla chips and stuffed the rest of the food into my backpack.
Ooh, jingle bells, fill that freezer up. Oh, what fun it is just drinking bourbon shooting. Nope.
Then I browsed through all the hangers in the shop and picked up a thick, kawaii sports winter jacket. Not a fan of the design, but I suppose a man shouldn't be picky in a situation like this. I also found a fisherman's suit, the kind you wear when you're working at a dock or on a boat. I checked the back of the shop too, where they usually store the perfect size shoes or the shirts with the better color. But man, I've got to hand it to you. When they tell you they don't have what you want in the back, they aren't lying. There was nothing better than what they had displayed in the front. I felt so bad for those people who work at retail stores. I had no idea. I then cleared more zombies and made my way into what appeared to be a pastry shop. I knew I shouldn't get my hopes up. It had been so long since the outbreak and most of the pastry items were probably long past their expiration date, but I checked anyways. Loads of pastry goods were just sitting there, rotten to the core. Chocolate dip, strawberry dip, apple fritters, Boston cream, glazed. Oh, who doesn't love glazed? The pain of seeing them like this was almost too much. I'm sorry I wasn't there to save you guys. The next store I visited was a convenience store. The amount of snacks and sodas I found there could probably last me a few more days. However, the problem was the fatigue I was experiencing. I couldn't, for the life of me, carry anything more in my backpack. Forcing it would not only cause more pain to my body, but also decrease my chances of surviving another horde attack, so I decided to take only a small portion and plan to return another time. The last stop on my list was an office unit. It could have been a law firm or an accounting company, I wasn't sure. It was filled with computers, loads of papers and pens. But here's the best part. It had a water dispenser holding gallons of fresh drinking water. Food is one thing, but a big jug of water supply? I was almost ready to risk my kneecaps for it. But then I got a reality check from the zombies lurking inside of the office building. I could barely swing my arms. I mean, just look at this. Trying to carry this thing all the way back to the mansion in my current state would be suicide. So I decided to head back for now, get some good rest, and then come back for the food and water dispenser.
I might look very ridiculous right now, but look at all these bodies, man. I did it. It was all me.
I followed the trail of death and destruction back to the mansion, dispatching a few zombies that were knocking on my walls, and dumped all my loot into storage. I tried organizing it for a while, but as I said, I'm not a fan of that. So I quickly gave up and began to disassemble TVs and more furniture to gain experience. At around 12 PM that night, I decided to finally sleep in a bed. I hadn't had a good night's sleep since I set foot on this island, and I had almost forgotten how a bed feels. It was so soft and comfortable. I closed my eyes, trying to savor this moment of satisfaction. And after a while, particles of light started to appear before me, floating and dragging a trail of lights behind them, almost as if they were painting a picture. The more they move around, the clearer the picture became. I saw the moon hanging high in the sky, veiled by thin strip of clouds, and the ocean reflecting the lights of the stars. And there I was, standing and taking it all in. Approximately 3 hours later, I woke up from my nap and felt hungry, so I headed straight to the kitchen. Now, today is December 16th, and December 16th turned out to be a strange day, filled with a lot of unusual occurrences. Okay, I don't even know where to begin. Okay, first things first, I couldn't hear. Yep, my hearing was completely gone. I had gone completely deaf in both ears. How did that happen? I don't know. It could be like a bacteria infection or just lack of sleep in general. But no matter how hard I tried, I couldn't fix it. My hearing did eventually return by the end of December 17th. However, on December 16th, I was completely deaf for the entire day. Due to my strained condition, I no longer felt safe heading back to the store to retrieve the food and the water dispenser. Instead, I decided to do some light inventory organizing, made some planks, and went outside to check on the school bus in the middle of the street. I had my eye on this bus ever since I got here. It was the perfect doomsday vehicle. It had both the power and the space for storage and day-to-day activities. Now, as I was checking on the bus to see what needed to be done to repair it, I noticed something moving in the corner of my eye. I immediately turned around, holding tight to my steel pipe, ready to fight. However, what I saw almost put me into shock. It was a person. A living, breathing person. You have no idea how happy I was to see another human being. Immediately, I started talking to him, asking his name, where he came from, and loads of other questions. However, halfway through our conversation, I realized that I couldn't hear any of the words I thought I was saying to him. And judging from his expression and lip movements, he was probably answering my questions as well, but I couldn't hear his responses either. The timing couldn't have been more terrible. I did my best to explain my problem to him and then signaled for him to follow me back to my base. I showed him around, gave him some of my spare clothing to wear, and explained the plan to retrieve food and drinks from the store. He displayed great patience throughout our interaction, and upon hearing my plan, he nodded with a big smile on his face. The two of us arrived at the store around 2:30, and the trip went much smoother than expected. I went ahead and grabbed everything from the cooler while my new friend guarded the entrance of the store. Coming back to the store with someone by my side was a completely different experience, and thanks to my new friend, we managed to clean out everything in the front rather quickly. However, at the back of the store, I discovered a bunch of lockers and some additional coolers. Now, what I found in those lockers felt like something you would expect to find inside a changing room of a secret military bunker. Just look at all this. Exoskeletons, tactical jackets, gas mask, and a breathing system? Did I accidentally stumble upon someone else's stash? Regardless, I took the entire exoskeleton suit and my new friend grabbed some tactical gear as well. Look at how impressive this gear looks. It would be a crime not to wear it. In addition to the super cool military equipment that made me feel like a god, we also found some medical supplies, and we made sure to grab those as well. We returned to the base at around 7 PM that night and deposited everything into the storage. While it was a good haul in terms of food and medical supplies, we still needed to find more nails to complete the defensive walls around the mansion. Feeling tired, the two of us sat down in the garage and just chilled there. I shared stories about my life in West Point, how I've become a mechanic, and even reminisced about my favorite brands of cigarettes back when they were options. The man just listened, occasionally gesturing for me to keep my voice down because I was being too loud, but I feel like both of us had a good time there. Bright and early on December 17th, I still couldn't hear anything. And my friend had left for a little adventure on his own to search for nails and possibly a generator. I decided to take a gas can out of the storage and siphon gas out of the cars that were scattered around the neighborhood. At around 4:30 in the afternoon, I met up with my friend, still holding an empty gas can. Despite finding multiple cars scattered around the mansion, they were all empty, and it seems that the gas in those cars had already evaporated. But the good news was that my friend had found a generator in the container area, the same place where I had killed a bunch of zombies and had a blackout. How did I miss that? Anyways, now that we have a generator, all we need was a bit of gas to get it running, and then we could bring it to a gas pump to quickly obtain a large volume of gas. On the morning of December 18th, I ventured out to the south side of the town, hoping to find even just a sliver of gas to get the generator running. And to my surprise, I got my hearing back. I could hear the birds, the rustling of the grass, and even the flies buzzing around the zombies' corpses. It was like being reborn into a new version of myself. I was eager to share this exciting news with my friend, but it appeared that he had already left the mansion. What are the odds? Things were a little better on the south side. I found a handful of cars that still had gas in their tanks. It wasn't much. Some of them only have a few drops, and others had about half a cup's worth. But it was enough for me to keep searching.
This is a new area.
An hour into the search, I found myself in an area that I haven't been to before. To my left, there were a series of townhouses, and zombies were pouring out of them. The zombies proved to be a very annoying distraction in my search for gas. Every few minutes, a new group would show up to harass me. I didn't want to simply walk inside of the building, since the interior structure could be difficult to maneuver. So I decided to stand my ground in the open and let them come to me. It felt like I was trapped in a never-ending loop. The ATV, just 4 steps away from me, had been my goal since I arrived in this area. 3 hours had passed, and my arms were growing tired, my swings slower and slower, I was sweaty, hungry, and the gas I had collected was starting to weigh me down.
This shit is crazy. Holy, what was that? How did I miss that swing?
I was starting to miss my hit, and a zombie seized the opportunity to lunge at my arm. I managed to push it away, but my hand was injured in the process. Thankfully, I wasn't a bite. I took my injury as a warning and called it a day. I applied an adhesive bandage to my hand and did a quick check to ensure I wasn't suffering from any more injuries. After that, I retraced my steps and returned to the mansion.
I'm back. I got some gas. It isn't much, but I think it's enough to run it for at least a couple of days. Man, you have no idea how crazy it was. I was at this condo and there were so many zombies. I fought them for hours and one of them actually managed to scratch my hand. Also, I got my hearing back, which is... Hello? Are you back? It's already 8. Where did he go?